Your doctor has recommended the removal of your gallbladder. But what does that actually mean? The gallbladder is a small organ located below the liver. Its function is to store bile used by the intestines to digest food. Gallstones, small calcified deposits, sometimes form and block the bile ducts, which lead from the gallbladder to the intestines. In many cases, the problem becomes so severe that the only effective treatment is to remove the entire gallbladder. This is the most common reason for gallbladder surgery. Other reasons for removing the gallbladder include chronic or severe infection or the growth of a tumor. Surgical procedures performed by making an incision large enough to expose the entire operative area are called open procedures. Your doctor believes that your medical condition and overall state of health make you a good candidate for a less intrusive laparoscopic surgery. A laparoscope is a narrow tube that contains a light source and a small video camera. Using a laparoscope, the surgeon is able to operate by making one or more very small incisions through which the sterile laparoscope and possibly other instruments are inserted into the body. Using the laparoscope's video camera, the surgeon is able to explore and inspect the interior of the abdomen, often allowing the surgeon to see with greater detail and with more clarity than with the human eye alone. However, it is important to understand that during the procedure, your surgical team is always prepared to convert a laparoscopic procedure to an open procedure, should they feel that your condition requires a more direct approach. If the surgical team makes this decision, you will find upon waking up that your doctor has made a larger incision and that healing may proceed more slowly. Converting to an open procedure will affect the length of your recovery and will probably require hospitalization. On the day of your operation, you will be asked to put on a surgical gown. You may receive a sedative by mouth, and an intravenous line may be put in. You will then be transferred to the operating table. In the operating room, a nurse will begin preparation by shaving the abdomen. The anesthesiologist will begin to administer anesthesia, most probably general anesthesia. The surgeon will then apply antiseptic solution to the skin around the area where the incisions will be made. Place a sterile drape around the operative site. Then, after you're asleep, your doctor will make a small vertical incision in your navel. Using a pair of small retractors, the surgeon will gently open the incision and divide the exposed tissues. Sutures, resembling a purse string, are placed in the skin around the navel. Next, a special instrument called a Hassan trocar is inserted through the opening in the navel. The purse string sutures are pulled, causing the skin to tighten around the instrument. This creates an airtight seal. The team then connects the trocar to a small hose in order to inflate the abdomen with carbon dioxide. This serves to enlarge the internal work area and to separate the organs. They will make three or more incisions into the abdomen, with care taken to keep the openings as small as possible. Next, the laparoscope is carefully inserted into the Hassan trocar. Once the laparoscope is in place, it will provide video images to allow placement of additional instruments. The surgeon will then locate and retract the liver to identify the gallbladder. Next, the surgeon removes the connecting tissue in order to expose the cystic duct and cystic artery.